seeking revenge, but things, they just got out of hand, and before you know it...
Gouge is missing, Dr. Beaton. An early steel scalpel.
I don't know where that went. I've been asking doctoral candidates. They have access to these tools for research.
25 centimeters long, 1 2 centimeters wide. That could definitely be the murder weapon.
Where were you on that night? Here. Working. I don't have to say anymore. If you have evidence, arrest me. I have work to do.
Isn't it weird that 3,000 years ago, a knock was a real guy? 24 years old, like Sphinx, living his life and falling in love.
Yeah, but I didn't know his afterlife was going to consist of being dissected and analyzed like what he really is. Just like your mask tools.
Yeah, that was the romantic notion I was going for, thank you.
Dr. Brennan wanted me to check on those particulate swabs from Lily's chest cavity. Not that I'm trying to rush you or anything.
Is everything okay, Daisy?
Lance and I had a little disagreement. He's overbearing and untrusting, and I'm evaluating the future of our relationship. You're so good to us. We're close, aren't we?
Hey, look what I found. Three different particulates within the chest cavity. We got crushed mammal bone, Kermes insect, woad, and the cube.
Animal, vegetable, and mineral. Actually, yep. That would be two animals and a vegetable, because bone is organic, not mineral. Oh my god.
The three particulates are totally different. But they're actually the exact same thing. Woad, Kermes insect, and bone were all used by the ancient Egyptians to make paint. I learned this when I was in art school. Bone for white, Kermes insect for red, and woad for indigo.
So we just can't make out the colors anymore because of tea color.
Right. Dr. Brennan thought perhaps the compaction was left by a canopic jar.
No. They didn't paint those. They weren't important. It would have been like painting Tupperware.
Something was paint.
And why did somebody hide it inside his body?
Well, it must have been important. And it needed to last forever. So if I can scan the cavity and find out where the paint seeped into the different tissues, I might be able to reconstruct what was in Anok's chest.
This is Zita Jabari from the Egyptian National Museum. Turn off that light.
What? Minute, we just discovered.
We have not authorized any invasive or investigative procedures on Anok. Ms. Jabari wants her mummy back. The boy with the bleeding heart goes back to Cairo today. Unless you'd like to start a feud between our two governments.
You have no legal grounds to keep him.
Yes, we do. A knock is evidence in a murder investigation. Whoever killed Dr. Caswell stole something from inside the mummy. Any idea what was inside that was worth killing for? Have you examined the CAT scans?
What CAT scans?
A few days ago, I granted Dr. Caswell's request to perform CAT scans on the knock. The film should be in Dr. Caswell's hands.
Dr. Caswell's lab?
No, I was just wondering.
And ask the young man who worked for Dr. Caswell. He's impressed.
Worked for Dr. Caswell at the Jeffersonian Institution. And I'm writing a request out of photograph information on the exhumation of the Knox tomb. Check with the museum unit for Dr. Caswell. That's why I'm here. For that and other reasons. She was murdered, so start talking.
Okay.
Not technically. I did not work for her, but Dr. Caswell did agree to be my doctoral advisor at the Antiquities Graduate Program.
Payback!
Thank you. Very bright. Okay, please, let's just stand in front of you. As soon as I got to D.C., Dr. Caswell said she did not have time for me anymore, that she was too busy prepping the Anok exhibit, but I knew. I even wrote a paper on this, my friend. Pissed you all off, didn't it, that she wouldn't let you help her?
No.
Yes, but not enough to kill her. I signed up as a museum intern so I could prove my value to her.
You thought if you helped her with the work, she might change her mind about advising.
It was my idea to do the CAT scans on Anok. She thought it was an excellent suggestion.
So, you saw the
existence.